Sometimes you might talk, but you show me love the way you pay attention. You notice everything.
Hello, queens. Welcome back to my channel. Today is going to be very quick, very simple. I know, that's beyond me. Whatever. So today's look is just going to be a simple fall look, and it's going to be very different for me because, as y'all know, like, it's pretty basic, you know, there's not really too much you can do with a fall look, you know, just, you know, a lot of dark colors and neutrals and browns. Anyway. So I think I'm gonna do that today. I did get a lot of requests for this look. I just need y'all to be my, like, really honest and be my eyes, because y'all could tell better than I could because y'all looking at me straight on. Are my eyebrows different? Because I feel like this one's more curved than this one on this side. So I need y'all to tell me the truth, because I feel like they look crazy. But in a sense, I really like them, which is weird. And yes, before you ask, this is all my hair. All my puff right there. From the edges to the puff, it's all mad. No, I'm just kidding. But seriously, I don't know what the hell I'm gonna do right now, y'all. I'm about to wing the shit out of this. So I hope you guys like it and enjoy. The first product we're going to be using is this Believe Beauty Concealer in the shade Beige. And it's pretty simple concealer, doe foot, you know. I'm going to use this to prime my eye like doe. Now, I already primed my eyes when I did my eyebrows off camera. And yeah, I did them off camera for a reason. Y'all need to see me do my eyebrows again, okay? Not that it's not that fun to watch. So I'm gonna prime my eyes like so, and I'm going to kind of set it in place for the powders to kind of get tacky, for it to get tacky so the powders can stick. So I'm going to be using Mr. Charles here. It's been through a lot. This palette has, yeah, it's seen everything at this point. I need to get the mini because it is so much easier to travel with that one than, yeah, y'all get the point. Anyways, moving along. So I think I want to do like a maroon rather than like an orange or like just a regular brown. I think I want to put some color into this. So what I'm going to do is, and like I always tell you guys, keep a wet makeup remover next to you because you have to clean off the excess from old, you know, looks on your brushes. I don't wash my brushes often because I only use them on my face. But in the sense that I do have to do another face, I always make sure I wash them. So, let's see. What color do I want to dab into first? So, I think I'm going to start with this brown color right here in the top corner. I think this is the top right corner. I don't remember the shade names. I'll put the shade names down in the description box once the video is over. And I'm just going to pack that on. I'm gonna pack that on to the corner outer V of my eye and kind of bring it around to the crease. And then I'm going to use another brush to kind of buff out the edges. So I'm going to go on like this light brown color right here. This light brown color there in the palette. And kind of blend out that outer edge. Can't beat that. Sorry, you guys, I have to switch mirrors. Okay, and then on top of that, I think I want to go in with like this. I want to say this is kind of like a plum color right here in the palette. Excuse the stain that's in the middle of it. Yeah, no, thing one and thing two destroys everything. So I'm going to take that color and I'm going to go back over top and, damn it, buff out the edges of that. So then, I'm going to go back in with that fluffy brush I had, and I'm going to pack back on that brown color we used earlier, just to kind of get it to come back and just kind of blend it back out a little bit in the crease. I think I want to do a halo eye. I like that idea. I like the idea of a halo. Kind of just amplified this whole look by like 3,000. Okay, so that's kind of the crease and outer V and shape that I'm going for this look. It blends together really well. Love this formula. So now I'm going to cut the halo. And I'm going to go back with that same concealer from a second ago. Put the halo out of that eye. And, ouch. What now? Lord. Here it is. I'm going to stamp that down to kind of get it to set in place. And then with a packer brush like this, and I'm going to go in with this color here. Ooh, I'm kind of torn now because this color and this shimmer shade, they're both really freaking pretty. I have an idea. I'm gonna use both. Just wait. So first I'm gonna go in with that more pinkish, purplish shimmer shade. And I'm going to pack that in on the lid. I think I'm gonna use my finger because for some reason your finger kind of always packs shimmer shades on better than a brush does. Not really too sure why. So, for whatever reason, it made that color intensify. Now, I'm gonna go in with that more orangey shimmer color that you saw in the palette and go over top. I'm gonna kinda like, now I'm gonna use the brush to do this effect. I'm going to blend them together to make them kind of merge as one on the eye. So they kind of come together. And all I'm doing is flipping the brush around because one side has one color, the other side has the other color. So I'm just kind of like going back and forth between the two just to kind of balance out the color line that makes them the same. Okay, now with that fluffy brush, I'm gonna brush that off. And I want to go in with like this brown, like this neutral brown shade right here. That's either xJames or 10% off, one of the two. I want to say that's 10% off. I use it quite often. But anywho, I'm going to go in and pack these two colors, well that, this color, in on either side of this halo. On either side, just to kind of soften out the edges. And then I want to go in with like this dark, plum color that's in the palette and stamp that in on both sides. And then some of this orange and like this like orangish reddish color. Kind of pat that in there too. Then I'm gonna go back and pat back on the shimmers. Gorgeous. Love it. Love it. Love it, love it, love it. Sorry. I just want to make sure you can see the orange color in the eye look when it's all laid. Okay, loves. Cute. Okay, so now what I want to do is, whoa, wee woo, Charlie. Now what I want to do is, I think I'm going to never mind. So now underneath the eye, I'm going to go in with that plum color I used earlier. And I'm going to stamp that on my lower lash line. And then go in with that plum, that darker plum color, and kind of just darken it out a little bit. And just smoke it out a little bit under the eye. I know right now it looks like I got punched in the eye, but once I add in everything, it's going to look fine. Okay, so I have this eyeliner, and it is in the shade Queen Morphe. So I'm gonna put that on the lower lash line. Lightly. I'm gonna use this wipe to kind of clean out some of this fallout that I have going on here. I don't appreciate it, but this is what the hell I signed up for. So this is one eye damn near completed. I'm not done yet. I'm getting there. Hold on. Hold on. I'm getting there. No, I'm just kidding. I cannot find my eyelash glue. So today I'm gonna be on some big ass eyelashes, bigger than normal. These are actually these are 5D. Who told me I could do 5D? No one. Don't you hate putting eyelash glue on your eyelash? Shit's stupid. I hate it. I would find a quicker way to fucking put on eyelashes. This shit takes too long. These eyelashes that I got from a costume store. I thought they were cute because I was a Bratz doll like one of the days of celebrating Halloween. And that was really, really cute. I might put a picture in there and kind of show you guys what I did. I don't really too much like it because I felt like it was like overdone, but whatever. Big ass eyelashes, I know, but I love it. I think they're so pretty. I think that they kind of give this eye look more drama, and that's kind of what I was going for. And it's a beautiful fall like type of look. I love it. So I'm gonna add on some of this really quick. Add on some mascara. I'm gonna put some mascara on, honey. And then I'm gonna go off camera and I'm going to put my other eye on. And I am back with both eyes totally complete and finished. I'll zoom in for you so you can kind of see what they look like up close. I know these are like the biggest fucking eyelashes and they're heavy as shit, which is why I keep batting them, but just bear with me. So you guys, I think y'all should tell me. Tell me your best like fall story with like your friends or like your boyfriend or whoever. In the comments, funny stories, Christmas stories, Thanksgiving stories, any type of stories. I have this one story that I tell everybody every year, my family at least. So one year my mom and my auntie had made this big like Thanksgiving dinner one year, and my cousin and his friend came home like super late one night. Everybody's asleep. Came home one night. And I don't know if they were drunk or high or what the hell, but they came home and they literally ate the entire turkey. No, I lied. The entire ham. They came home and ate. No, actually, they came home and ate both entire turkey and ham and left nothing for nobody for the next day. Mind you, this shit, Thanksgiving was the next day. And they came home and demolished everything. my mom and my auntie woke up beyond hot. Like, they were boiling because we literally had nothing else to eat for Thanksgiving. Like, you know, all the sides and stuff were made, yeah, but it wasn't like, you know, the main courses were gone pretty much. So yeah, we never knew why they came in and did it. They just did. Like, they just, I guess they say they forgot, but I doubt it, because they knew, like, there was hella food in the kitchen. It wasn't here for no reason. So yeah, anyways, that's my traditional story that I tell every year around Thanksgiving. So you guys, you tell me your funny stories down below in the comments, and the funniest one will be featured probably in my next video. Yeah, I'm gonna feature the funniest comment in my next video, and I'm gonna shout out whoever that is. Anyways, now it's on to my base look, and I know you guys are sick of my base look too, because I'm sick of it. So I'm probably gonna do that off camera too. Yep, I'm gonna do my base off camera. So I'm gonna go do my base off camera, and then I will be back for the final and finished look. So here is the final and completed look. I think it came out really beautifully. All the colors blended together stunningly. I love the choice that I picked for the lip. I actually kind of want to add a little more highlight to the lip. Just, there we go. Just add a little more pucker. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know it was kind of quick, kind of fast, but that was the point. I didn't want a very long video like all my other ones. This one's gonna be a little bit shorter. So I hope you guys like the look. Comment down below. Let me know how you feel. Let me know if I need, maybe I should do a different nude, a different color. Maybe there's something on my face that could have been applied differently. Whatever you guys feel. But I know I love it. I hope you guys really like it. And I'm gonna come in a little closer. I don't really too much like people being in my face because of the texture, but there it is, all done. I hope you guys love it.